Hi, this is Sarah Marks, one of the librarians here at UMass Lowell. For this video today, we're going to talk about the difference between finding research articles in Google and finding research articles in our databases, and some important differences in what kind of results you're getting. So here's what you need to know about doing research for the next 4 years. We are looking for you to use articles that we call peer-reviewed, scholarly, or academic. But what they really are is research articles. In them, experts, your authors, your professors, do some sort of research. It might be an experiment or interviews or looking at data from other sources, and then draw some conclusions about it. This is different from what you're used to experiencing online. For example, here we have a Google search, and I've just done a search for diabetes. The research results include websites for associations that support research or information about diabetes. Medline Plus, government websites that are designed to give you background information. WebMD, which is designed for people who might think they have diabetes or do have diabetes. The Mayo Clinic, who treat diabetes. And you're going to have Wikipedia. Let's talk about Wikipedia briefly. What is Wikipedia? You use it every day. And you probably don't even think about it. But Wikipedia is one thing and one thing only, an encyclopedia. It's all it wants to be, and it's all it's trying to be. The difference between research and an encyclopedia is one idea. This is not the research. This is somebody looking at everything out there and summarizing it in a way that is easy to understand to someone who doesn't know anything. An encyclopedia, like World Encyclopedia or Encyclopedia Britannica, is not what we use for research in academia. So for the next 4 years, while I can tell you Wikipedia is one of the best sites out there, it's not what your professors are looking for you to use, and thus no longer appropriate as a research tool. I can talk to you more about Wikipedia in other videos or one-on-one, but it's a good starting point. It's not a good ending point. Your best way to use Wikipedia is to scroll down and look at their references. And remember, when your professors ask you to find 5 sources, Wikipedia on diabetes has found 115 as of this video, and it grows all the time. But what they're showing you is that they take the research seriously and they want to use quality sources. What should you look for if you're starting at Wikipedia? In the case of health research, look for PMID. This is PubMed. This is a major research database. Or a DOI number, which is a unique code that applies to only one article. So every time you see a DOI number, it's only going to take you to this specific article. PMIDs and DOIs are linked within Wikipedia, and you can even Google this, and it will take you right to this article. So you can find scholarly articles in Google, but it takes a lot of work. Even if you choose to use Google Scholar, you spend a lot of time looking at things that aren't relevant and trying to figure out how to focus your search. What the library's databases do is focus you in. They are search engines. We call them databases. And when you're searching a database, you're searching a specialized collection, primarily of scholarly peer-reviewed research articles. While we're here, let's look at the PDF because I want to give you some quick tips on how to identify something that's research. Look here. At the very top, it says that it's research. If you read this, it's not easy to understand. It's not written for people in the world. It's written for other experts. You'll typically have long lists of authors. You'll see their background, the places they work, and how to get in touch with them. There'll be universities or hospitals. Here's how to contact one of them. Science articles especially will give you this abstract. This is a summary of the article, and it's written in a way to help you decide if the rest of the article is worth your time. So they'll tell you the objective of the research. Why did they do this? How did they design their research? This case, a review of other literature was done. What their sources were for information. and if there were criteria that they used to determine what was included. The results are summarized, as are their conclusions. These are not things you can quote. They're to use to help you decide if the other 9 pages of this article are worth your time. Articles that are peer-reviewed tend to not be very exciting to look at least. They might include charts, graphs, tables, but they won't include ads, they won't include pictures, unless it's relevant to the research. And finally, at the very end, just like we're going to ask you do for every paper you write, you're going to see a list of references, and we're excited. In the next video, we're going to talk about how the databases make this a little easier, especially one database, Medline.